I walked down Nevsky, submerged in my thoughts. I should go right away to the building supper and tell him everything. And after I have finished with the old woman, I will stand by the bakery day in and day out until I see that nice little lady. After all, I owe her 48 kopecks for the bread. I have an excellent excuse to search for her. The vodka was still having its effect, and it seemed that everything was coming together nice and easy. On the Fontanka, I approached a kiosk, and with the leftover change, I drank a large mug of bread beer. The bread beer was bad and sour, and I walked on with a vile taste in my mouth. On the corner of Litania, some drunk staggered and pushed me. It's good thing that I don't have a revolver. I would have killed him right on the spot. I must have walked all the way home with an angry scowl on my face. In any case, almost everyone I passed turned to look at me. I walked into the building supper's office. On the desk sat a quiet, dirty, pugnosed, cross-eyed, and fair-headed girl, rubbing her lips with rouge and gazing into a compact mirror. "And where is the supper? I asked. The girl was silent, still rubbing her lips. "Where the supper?" I repeated in a sharp voice. "Tomorrow, not today," answered the dirty, pug-nosed, cross-eyed and fair-headed girl. I walked out into the street. On the opposite side walked a cripple on the mechanic leg, knocking loudly with his leg and his stick. Six little boys ran after the cripple, mocking his gait. I turned into my vestibule and started climbing the stairs. On the second floor, I stopped. A disgusting thought went through my head. The old woman must have begun to decompose. I hadn't closed the windows, and they say that with open windows, dead people decompose more quickly. Utter stupidity, and that damned supper won't be in till tomorrow. I stood there several minutes in indecision and climbed onward. I stopped again at the door to my apartment. Maybe I should go down to the bakery and wait for that sweet little lady. I would plead with her to let me stay at her place for two or three nights. But then I remember that she's already bought bread today, and that means she won't be going to the bakery, and anyway, nothing would come of it. I unlocked the door and walked into the hallway. At the end of the hallway, a light was on, and Maria Vasilievna, holding some sort of rag in her hand, was rubbing it with another rag. Seeing me, Maria Vasilievna shouted, "An old man was working for you." "What old man?" "I don't know," Maria Vasilievna answered. "When was it?" I asked. "Also don't know," said Maria Vasilievna. "Was it you who talked to the old man?" I asked Maria Vasilievna. "I," answered Maria Vasilievna. "So how is it that you don't know when?" I said. "2 hours or so ago," said Maria Vasilievna. And what did this old man look like? I asked. I also do know, said Maria Vasilievna, and went away into the kitchen. I went to my room, and what if, I thought, the old woman vanished? I'll walk into the room and the old woman gone. My God, are there really no miracles? I unlocked the door and slowly pushed it ajar. Maybe I only imagined it, but the sickeningly sweet smell of decay wafted in my face. I peeked around the slightly open door and for a moment was frozen to the spot. The old woman was on all fours, slowly crawling towards me. With a shout, I slammed the door, turned the key and jumped back again against the wall opposite the door. Maria Vasilievna appeared in the hallway. Do you call for me? She asked. I was shaking so bad that I couldn't answer and only shook my head no. Maria Vasilievna came closer. You were talking to someone? She said. Again, I shook my head no. Crazy, said Maria Vasilievna and walked back into the kitchen, looking back at me several times on her way. Can't stand here like this. Can't stand here like this, I repeated to my thoughts. The phrase came together somewhere inside me. I chanted it until it made it all the way to my consciousness. Yes, I can't stand here like this, I said to myself, but continued standing there like I was paralyzed. Something awful had happened, but ahead of me there was something that had to be done that was perhaps even more awful than what had already happened. A whirlwind spun my thoughts around in circles and I could see only the restful eyes of the dead old woman as she slowly crawled towards me on all fours.